Hello students, today we will discuss few more questions of chapter 3. We will see which questions are related to the chapter 3 we have completed, which topics we have completed. So A and B we have completed yesterday, we have discussed. Now let us start from C. Choose the correct option. The process of taking in food through the mouth is called ingestion. Ingestion is the process of taking in food through the mouth. Two number, saliva contains salts, mucus, enzymes. It will be all of them. Saliva contains salts, mucus and enzymes, all of them. The enzymes that changes casein into insoluble curd, it will be renin. Renin is the enzyme that changes casein into insoluble curd. It is given in the book. Actually, all the questions are given in the book. We have discussed also. Another name of the windpipe is trachea. Then D number, identify the errors in the given statements. One number, tongue is the fleshy muscular organ free at the back of the buccal cavity and attached in the front. No, it will be attached at the back of the buccal cavity and free in the front. Two number, the large intestine is the long tube about 7 meter long. No, it will be 1.5 meter long. The larynx leads to the pharynx. No, it is wrong. The pharynx leads to the larynx. Now come to short and precise. A number, one number is related. Show the following process in the form of flowchart. Absorption and ejection of digested food. Let us see how to draw. Food in the small intestine undergoes digestion. After digestion, food can be categorized into digested food and undigested food. Digested food like glucose, amino acid, fatty acids, they are absorbed by the villi in the small intestine itself and then it mixes in the bloodstream. But what happens to the remaining undigested food? It goes to the large intestine. Here water is absorbed and then it moves to the rectum. It is stored there in the form of feces. At regular interval of times, it is thrown out of the body. This is the flowchart of the absorption and ejection of the digested food. B number, which questions are related? 1, 2, 3, 4 are related. I'll discuss 2 and 4. They are a little tough. Villi have a network of very fine blood capillaries. The small food molecules like glucose, fatty acid, amino acid, these have to be absorbed by villi and these have to be sent in the blood. They have to be mixed in the blood and that's why villi have a network of very fine blood capillaries. Now, four number, the opening of windpipe is guarded by a muscular flap. The opening of windpipe is guarded by a muscular flap to avoid the food from going inside the windpipe. The food that we eat can go in the windpipe, that should be avoided. So the opening of windpipe is guarded by a muscular flap. C number 1, what is peristalsis? In C number 1, 2, 3 questions, question number 1, 2, 3 are related. Let us see one number, what is peristalsis? The wave-like motion of esophagus due to the contraction of its muscles when the food moves forward in the esophagus is called peristalsis. Next question is, what is emulsification of fats? Breaking down of large fat globules into tiny droplets so that enzymes can act on them is called emulsification. And three number is, explain the role of large intestine. After the digestion of food in the small intestine, the food moves to the large intestine. The large intestine absorbs the water from this food. Large intestine does not participate in the digestion but helps in the helps prevent the loss of water. Thus, it helps in conservation of water in the body. This is the role of large intestine. Then at length, come to at length. A number 1 and 2 are related. Chyme, after the digestion of food in the stomach, the food changes to a pulp-like thick paste called chyme. This is the explanation, this is the definition of chyme. Then, what is assimilation? The conversion of digested food like glucose, amino acid, fatty acid to another form for later use is called assimilation. बी नंबर वन एंड टू आर रिलेटेड, डिफ्रेंशिएट बिटवीन, यू विल डू योर सेल्फ. नाउ सी नंबर, सी नंबर वन टू थ्री आर रिलेटेड, आई एम एक्सप्लेनिंग यू वन नंबर. सिमिलरली यू विल ट्राई योर सेल्फ टू एंड थ्री. सो द क्वेश्चन नंबर वन इज, गिव द लोकेशन ऑफ द फोर टाइप्स ऑफ टीथ अलॉन्ग विद देयर फंक्शंस. देयर आर फोर टाइप्स ऑफ टीथ इन आवर माउथ, इंसीजर, कैनाइंस, प्रीमोलर्स एंड मोलर्स. इंसीजर, दीज आर लोकेटेड इन द फ्रंट ऑफ द माउथ. देयर आर फोर इंसीजर्स इन द अपर जॉ एंड फोर इन द लोअर जॉ. दे आर यूज फॉर कटिंग एंड बाइटिंग द फूड. कैनाइंस, दीज आर लोकेटेड नेक्स्ट टू द इंसीजर, वन ऑन ईच साइड. दस देयर आर टू कैनाइंस इन द अपर जॉ एंड टू इन द लोअर जॉ. दे आर यूज फॉर पियर्सिंग एंड टियरिंग द फूड. Premolars, there are two premolars next to the canines on each side of the jaw. Thus, they are four in the upper jaw and four in the lower jaw. They are used for crushing and grinding the food. And molars, these are the last three teeth on each side of the both the jaws next to the premolars. Thus, there are six molars on the upper jaw and six in the lower jaw. They are used for chewing and grinding the food. At last, you will draw the diagram of the teeth in the mouth.